Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss about A1 milk, A2 milk, everything about it, like from where it is coming, which is better, why is not the other one better for us, and everything related to it. So, A1 milk producing cow breeds are Curran Swiss, Holstein Friesian, Red Danish, and some other exotic cows. A2 milk are A2 milk is produced by some pure line without any exotic inheritance cows like Gir, Sahiwal, Thalparkar. Although one thing I must tell you here that not all the exotic cow breeds are producing A1 milk, and also not all the Indian breed cows are producing A2 milk. Okay, from where A1 milk or A2 milk concept, from where it is coming, that I'll tell you now. It actually depends on the protein that the cow milk is carrying. Cow milk has 3.2% of protein, out of which 80% is casein protein, out of which 30 to 35% is beta casein. And beta casein has several different variants, out of which A1 beta casein and A2 beta casein are the main. Now, the type of milk depends on the allele that is coding for the beta casein protein. That is the A1 allele or A2 allele. If the A1 allele is expressing, thus it will produce A1 beta casein, and thus the milk will be called A1 milk. Now these two are some beautiful representation that I found from a journal. Now the dot shows the A1 allele frequency and the star shows the A2 allele frequency. And the left one is for the European bovine breeds, right one is for Indian cattle breeds. You can see that Guernsey is a cow that has about 96 to 98% of A2 allele frequency. While Red Danish, on the other hand, is also an exotic cow, and it is producing 23% of A2 allele frequency. So Guernsey is having predominance of A2 allele, unlike what is usually thought that all the exotic cows are producing A1 milk. So you can see Guernsey is actually not producing A1 milk. On the right side you can see Sahiwal, Thalparkar, some water buffaloes, these are having no A1 allele frequency and just A2 allele frequency, and thus producing pure A2 milk. When these are crossbreds like Curran Fries, Curran Swiss, then they are having the A1 allele frequency too. How A1 milk, or how the concept of A1 milk or A1 allele came, is there was a single gene mutation some 8000 years ago in Holsteins, resulting in the production of A1 beta casein protein in this breed. This mutation in the beta casein gene led to 12 genetic variants, of which A1 and A2 are most common. B is also there, several different variants are there, so A1 and A2 are the most common. How A1 milk or A1 inheritance came to our genetic structure is, when India's milk production was not enough for the population, then there was a shift from the indigenous cows that gave A2 milk. Because the quantity of milk was less to exotic breeds or crossbreds. The mutation that occurred was passed on to the many other indigenous breeds, principally because Holsteins are used to genetically improve the production of other breeds. While dairy herds in much of Asia, Africa, and part of Southern Europe, not just India, okay, Asia, Africa, and part of Southern Europe remain naturally high in cows producing A2 milk, the A1 version of the protein is common among cattle in the Western world. Now, this is a very important thing to understand the health aspect or the health consequence of A1 milk and A2 milk. Proteolytic digestion of A1 milk and A2 milk is different. The product of proteolytic digestion of A1 milk produces BCM7, while that of A2 milk produces BCM9. The difference in beta casein A1 and A2 is shown as position number 67. Proline at 67th position in beta casein A2 is replaced with histidine in beta casein A1. which milk is better health-wise. Now, A2 milk is better because it does not produce BCM7 on digestion, which A1 milk does. Now, what does BCM7 actually do and why is it the so-called culprit in every health aspect related to milk? Now, sorry, A1 milk. So, BCM7 possibly cause oxidation of LDL, which when engulfed by macrophages called cause atherosclerosis in heart. There are some other experiments also where it was seen when a scratch is made on the in the blood vessels and even milk is fed, then there is more deposition as compared to A2 milk. So more cases of obstruction, more cases of heart problems were seen in cases of A1 milk. Now, some neurological disorders. Epidemiological studies presented in one of the patent applications that statistically relevant correlation exists between beta-casein A1 consumption and aggravation of neurological disorders such as autism and schizophrenia. What is statistically relevant correlation is that when a lot of several countries were compared and it was seen that A1 milk consuming countries were having more cases of autism and schizophrenia as compared to A2 milk. Okay. Also, there is one more evidence to its relation to autism and schizophrenia that it was seen that large amount of BCM7 was found in the urine of the patient suffering from autism and schizophrenia. Such patients have shown dramatic improvement in their symptoms following gluten-free and casein-free diet. Now, its relation to type 1 diabetes. In type 1 diabetes, what happens is beta cells of pancreas is destroyed by immune system of the host. Now, the role of BCM7 here is it suppresses the body's immune system that may enhance the survivability of the pathogens such as enteroviruses or bacteria like Mycobacterium avium. These pathogens are ultimately involved in trigger of type 1 diabetes like symptoms. Second theory says autoantibody generation occurs against beta cells. According to this theory, some of the peptide sequences of beta casein, which are produced during digestion, mimic the sequence of GLUT2 transporter that is involved in glucose transportation in cell. In this response, T cells recognize them as antigen and activate B cells for production of antibodies. Antibodies not only target the digested segment of beta casein product but also to insulin producing beta cells causing type 1 diabetes. So both of these things are saying that there is some kind of correlation between BCM7 being produced by A1 milk and type 1 diabetes. The potential role, make this point clear that the potential role of cow's milk in diabetes is still debated and there is no consensus on the diabetogenicity of individual milk proteins. Okay, so again I'm telling that the CVD disorder that we saw, the neurological disorder or diabetes, there is no direct evidence showing that the A1 milk is causing these problems, but there are epidemiological studies, there are experiments done on laboratory animals that show that A1 milk is causing or may be a potential cause of these diseases. I hope A1 milk and A2 milk is clear in your minds after this video. Thank you for watching. Please do like the video and subscribe to my channel.